Hello. In this video, we'll talk about reactions of alkenes. Alkenes are relatively more active than alkanes. Similar to all other unsaturated compounds, they may give addition reaction. They may give addition reaction with hydrogen halogens, hydrogen halides, water molecules. Let's see them one by one. Let's assume that we have ethylene molecule and we're trying to add hydrogen to this one. In order to have this reaction, you need to have some nickel catalyst in the medium. So, what happens is that one hydrogen adds to the first carbon, one hydrogen adds to the second carbon atom. So that CH2 becomes a CH3, the second one also becomes a CH3. And the double bond between them changes into a single bond. A similar reaction we have in the second case. So, we have chlorine here, Cl2, one of the chlorines adds to the first carbon, other chlorine adds to the second one. So it becomes CH2Cl and another CH2Cl. Now both carbon atoms are making 1, 2, 3 bonds. They need one bond only, so the double bond changes into a single bond. Let's see the third case, addition of hydrogen halides. So, I have hydrogen halide to be added. Hydrogen goes to one carbon, chlorine goes to the other one. So CH2 becomes CH3 and the second CH2 becomes CH2Cl. In this case, it doesn't matter where you add chlorine because in both cases, what you'll get is chloroethane. Let's add water in the third case. When we say water, you can think it as HOH. You add hydrogen to one of the carbons and OH to the other one. So the first CH2 will become CH3, the second CH2 will become CH2OH. And similarly, the double bond between them will become a single bond. Now let's have a look at the last reaction. We have propene reacting with hydrogen chloride. This is not going to change because it has no double bond, so it's going to be again CH3. Let's say that chlorine goes to the second carbon atom, so it's CH with a chlorine. And the last one is taking the other hydrogen, it was CH2, it becomes CH3. The product of the reaction is 2-chloropropane. But in fact, depending on the conditions of the reactions, it's also possible to add your chlorine to the first carbon atom. If you do so, it's going to give you CH3, CH2, CH2, Cl. If you're interested in this in deeper, you can check the Markovnikov and anti-Markovnikov rules. The second reaction that I'm going to show you is oxidation reaction. Oxidation of alkenes is a little bit complicated, so I'll give you only one case about the oxidation. So the case with hot concentrated manganate 7 solution. So if you have such an oxidizing agent medium there, with this compound, you'll get two compounds. How are you going to get that? By the breakage of the double bond in here. So this carbon atom will be oxidized and this carbon atom will be oxidized. Let's see the products. So it's going to be CH3C, double bonded oxygen, hydrogen, it's an aldehyde. And this one actually, let's write from here, CH3, another carbon, another hydrogen again, and it will be oxidized with an oxygen in here. So in this case, my products were two aldehydes. They are the same aldehydes actually, you can see it right here, at 2. Let's check the case in here. We have, again, BH2 in, but we have some branches in here, methyl and methyl. In this oxidation reaction, again, this double bond is going to break from here. So I'm going to get CH3, this one, then this carbon atom, then this carbon atom. But this is going to be the one which is oxidized, so it's going to give you this one. And the same thing in here, you see CH3. The next carbon atom which had a double bond and it is attached to another CH3 group. So it is oxidized with a double bond oxygen like this. So in the first oxidation reaction, we get aldehydes from the oxidation of an alkene. In the second reaction, we obtain some ketones from the oxidation of my alkene. The third chemical reaction of alkenes is polymerization reaction. In polymerization reactions, small alkene molecules, which we call monomers, come together to produce a huge molecule, which we call a polymer. Let's see polymerization of ethene in the first place. This is our ethene. During the polymerization reaction, the double bond between the alkenes open up. So, such a unit is formed, CH2, CH2. But I have a lot of this one, so I'll have more of it, CH2 with another CH2, CH2 with another CH2. But as you see, all these carbon atoms in here are making three bonds only. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. But as we know, carbon atoms should make four connections. So what happens is that this carbon atom connects to this carbon atom. This carbon atom connects to this carbon atom. This carbon atom connects to the carbon atom of the next unit. This carbon atom connects to the carbon atom of the previous unit. I'm gonna write it like this. So, what we end up with is something like this. I have CH2 with another CH2. The double bond is not in here anymore. It's a single bond. And I have this unit repeating itself several times. This and that are representing that this unit is connected to several other such units. Now let's write the equation for polymerization for propene. Propene is alkene with three carbon atoms. When you're writing polymerization reactions, I recommend you to write the double bonded carbon atoms on the same line, on the same plane, and all others either up or down. I put my third carbon atom down like this. Then what happens in polymerization reaction? One more time, let's remember. So the double bond opens up. So my CH2, CH is here still, but the double bond is now a single bond. And I have a CH3 in here. So this is going to connect to the next unit, and this is going to connect to the previous unit. And this is the formula of my polymer. And finally, polymerization of chloroethane. Again, as you see, I have written it in that way. Double bonded carbon atoms are on the same line. Okay, I have chlorine extra, I put it on another line. What happens in here is the same again. I have CH2 and a CH. Double bond becomes a single bond. I put my chlorine down here again. This is going to connect with the next unit, this is going to connect with the previous unit, and this is going to be the formula of my polymer. If you have N chloroethanes, then you are going to end up with this one. Let's name these compounds also. So we started with ethene, so this is going to be called polyethene. It's often called polyethylene. This is propene, this is going to be polypropene. Or very often it's called polypropylene. And this is going to be called polychloroethene. It's very often called polyvinyl chloride as well. That's all for this video.